you. Thank you. Thank you. It's a privilege to be here, and I'm going to talk about a growing movement in global health really focused on mental health, and I'll talk specifically about some of our activities at Partners in Health. I want to start with some background. In our culture, we have a lot of difficulty talking about mental illness, and across cultures, we have a lot of difficulty talking about mental illness. And I'm going to talk specifically today about how we are addressing mental illness, and whatever we each call it, mental disorder, mental illness, mental health problems, these are today the most significant cause of suffering and disability in the world. Did you know that in 15 years, depression alone will be the number one cause of disability globally, above heart disease, cancer, and HIV? Here in the US, 1 in 4 Americans suffers from a mental disorder, and last year, 60% of those people went without treatment. Why is that? We have treatments that work. Prevention works, early intervention works. And globally, new data that came out last year in The Lancet estimated that 45% of kids, of youth, age 10 to 24, struggle with mental disorder. And that's particularly disheartening given the fact that in low-income countries, 85% of people suffering from mental disorder go without treatment. Let's take a step back. Esther's a young woman who we met in Haiti a couple months before this picture was taken. She was found in the countryside, paranoid and hearing voices in her head. She came to one of our hospitals and received treatment that included social assistance, basic psychological support, and medication. 2 years later, she continues to be happy and symptom-free. Her dignified recovery transformed perceptions about mental health and mental illness in the community as a treatable condition. So simple, affordable interventions are life-saving for people who have these problems, rich or poor. Now, here's the problem. This is Tatiana, the psychologist who took care of Esther. She's one of a very small number of psychologists in Haiti. And if you look globally, in Haiti, there are approximately 5 psychiatrists and 1 neurologist serving 10 million people. And this is a global phenomenon. In Rwanda, where we also work, there are 2 psychiatrists and 1 neurologist serving 10 million people. So we know that we have to train more specialists, but we also know that the answer doesn't lie with specialist care. And another issue is that when disasters happen, such as in Haiti, there's an immediate interest in mental health, often, sometimes not, but that interest is fleeting. So there's really a lack of resources for either emergency mental health care or long-term systems. So these are the challenges we face. Soon after the earthquake, a small group of us at PIH mobilized a mental health response. The organization mobilized with us, and our response was significant. But our intent following the earthquake was to do what we could with the emergency, but to really develop ongoing, long-term systems of care in mental health. And ultimately, we felt we had no choice given conditions that existed at the 2 psychiatric hospitals that exist in Haiti. This is a patient, not a prisoner. And so, what we resolved was that we needed to shift care to non-specialist providers and community health workers, CHWs like Benny Soit here. This is called task sharing, and it's been used in HIV care. And using qualitative and quantitative research design science, we've been working with colleagues to create tools to support safe, evidence-based provision of care, such as mental health screening and symptom tracking tools, which reflect local, culturally appropriate idioms of distress and illness. Over the next 3 years, we will be scaling up mental health services in Haiti's Central Plateau, where Partners in Health sister organization Zamila Santé operates 10 hospitals within a network of 2,500 community health workers, serving about 1/6 of the country, or 1.2 million people. We also are going to be working closely with the schools of medicine and nursing to build and support the strengthening of national institutions. If our pilot is successful, the government can take the tools with the possibility of scaling up more broadly to non-governmental and governmental entities who ideally should be working together and sharing methods and practices. This is going to require new forms of coordinated communication and collaboration focused on mental health, including a diverse range of stakeholders. We believe that this offers a very good chance to develop sustainable, long-term, and lasting community-based mental health services in Haiti. And in closing, I want to ask all of you to please lend your creativity, your expertise, and your passion to helping move forward this important, urgent movement in global mental health. Thank you.